Carbone! Al Carbone! Al Carbone! Al Carbone! Al Carbone!
Thanks, Al. We want to thank you for everything that you do for our team and for the school. And congrats on retirement. And finally, we'd like to thank you for everything that you do for this school.
Congrats, Al. Happy retirement. Cheers!
In my class of 06, just want to say thank you very much for everything you did. It's been a pleasure, man. Dealing with all the phone calls at 3 a.m., telling people we're arrested, when in doubt, we weren't, and freaked out every single time. But always good time, Al. Al and pal. Appreciate it, and best of luck to everyone. Bye.
Bye. T-Bone. Jack Devaney here, class of 05. I just want to say thank you on behalf of a few of my classmates who definitely would not have gotten into college if it wasn't for you.
Mr. Al Carbone, a.k.a. Chief, I'm wishing you all the best from Denver. Congratulations to you on such a storybook career at the Q. Chief, you're one of a kind, man of his word, and the only guy I know that visits the local tanning beds more often than Zurinsky. And the entire female student body.
Hi, Grandpa Al.
Hi, Grandpa. Hi, Grandpa Al.
Congratulations. We're so excited for you. Quinnipiac's going to miss you like crazy, just like we will. Hopefully we see you soon, and we love you lots. From Johnny, Candace, Roddy, Ben, Jose, and Rosalie. Love ya. Bye.
Just wanted to thank you from the class of 2006 and from Reader and I. We really appreciate all you've done for everybody, including getting us all into college. I do have a couple questions for you. Are you still the most jacked and tan guy in Hamden? And I hope Social Security is going to pay for meals now, because no more freebie on Rand's dime. Last question before I go. How the hell did Tori Guida get into Providence and not Quinnipiac? Be good, man. Best of luck. Love you.
Al has starred in dozens of national TV commercial ads, playing difficult roles such as a strip of Hormel bacon, a leather belt, the after photo in a Bosley hair commercial, the before photo in a Men's Health ad, and the during photo in a Cialis ad.
He inspired the character Mr. Rogers.
Well, Seabone, it's about that time to ride off into the sunset.
Hey, Al, congratulations on your retirement. It feels like it was just yesterday. I was sitting in your office with my mother, and you turned up the charm to make sure we were heading to Quinnipiac. It was one of the best choices I ever made. I think I speak on behalf of all the boys when I say thank you for everything you did for us over the years. And best luck in your next chapter. I'm sure we'll be seeing a lot of you.
Hey, Al. Congratulations on retirement. Quite an achievement. I know the organization wouldn't be where it was today without you.
Yeah, it was always great seeing you around campus. It's quite the achievement, and I'm sure you'll be missed, but we'll obviously see you around the rink a lot.
You're always a really great ambassador for not only the university, but the team, so I appreciate everything you've done for me and all of us to get us here.
Thanks, Al, for making us feel like a family while we were here right from the start and through the end, and now that we're graduated and continuing that. Thank you.
Thanks, Al. Always a great guy to be around, and obviously, you know, we don't take you for granted. We know how important you were to our team and our program, so thanks a lot. You'll be missed.
So we have this Super Bowl party at our house in here, and a lot of people are there, and Al decides he's off with the younger, some of the younger guys there, and decide, younger coaches or whatever, and decides he's gonna do some Zambuca shots, and has a little more than he needs, and next thing I know, the game's going on, and he's fast asleep on the couch, and there's 30 people around him watching the game. It was the Patriots' first Super Bowl, when Vinatieri, you know, hits that kick at the end, And anyway, as the game goes on, people just forget about Al, and the party's great, we're all having fun, and we get to that end point where Vinatieri's lining up for the kick, and everybody's focused on the TV, and all of a sudden we realize that Al has awoken, and he's staggering around, trying to get his bearings, and starts to stumble literally towards the TV with his hands like this, and someone yells out, "He's trying to block the kick!" And Jeff Blanch jumps in and catches him and pulls him away, and then Vinatieri buried it. But it was great. And then the follow-up to that is, all right, well, who's going to take Al home? And Jim Kirby, bless his soul, God, I miss him, He's like, I'll take him home and drop him off. And I think the story goes, I wasn't there, but I think the story goes is he left Al on the front steps, rang the doorbell, and ran to his car and booted out of there.
The good news is that you're retiring. Bad news is you'll probably be around the office a heck of a lot more. So I guess we'll be seeing you. But congratulations and thanks for everything.
Just sharing a few little moments about Al. Just wanted to say we will all miss him very much. We all love him here at the hockey office and the hockey team and staff as well. We won't miss his long voice messages or his 4 a.m. text messages.
Our program would not be in the same place without you. And we look forward to many years to come with you being a huge part of our hockey program. So congratulations again. From the bottom of my heart, I love you. And I thank you for all you've done, again, for me personally. And for our men's hockey program here.
When people talk about Al, there's usually three things that comes to mind most of the time. First one is piece of work. Second thing is inappropriate. And the third thing is hard goal. And you know, those to me are the three best descriptions of Al. But we'll focus on the hard goal. And Al, you do have that. I appreciate your 21 years of friendships and everything you've done. Not only for me as a person and for my family, but also for our program. The friendships that we've developed with our players, you know, just makes their experience that much better. And when our alums go out in the world and say how much they love playing hockey at Quinnipiac and love the university, that helps us recruit. And you've done wonders to help us reach the levels that we have, and I sincerely appreciate that.